Hello everyone. So today we're going to be talking about abstract and concrete nouns. So let's get started. First of all, what is a noun? A noun is a word that tells the name of a person, a place, an animal, a thing, or an idea. A few examples could be, a person could be man, woman, teacher, or names also like John and Mary. Place, home, office, town, countryside, America. Thing, table, car, banana, money, music, love. Animal, dog, monkey, rabbit, elephant, penguin, squirrels. What are concrete nouns? A concrete noun is a noun that you can see, hear, smell, touch, or taste. In an easy way, a concrete noun is a noun that you can identify using your five senses. For example, dogs, cats, a Rubik's Cube, a bottle, all of these examples are concrete nouns. A few more examples are, a strawberry milkshake that tastes sweet and feels cold is an example of a concrete noun because we can taste and feel it. A mango tree is something that we can see and has a physical existence, so it is a concrete noun. A parrot looks cute and feels soft, so it is a concrete noun as we can see and feel it. The sun we see shines brightly, hence it is a concrete noun because we can see it. What are abstract nouns? Abstract nouns are nouns that you cannot see, hear, smell, or taste, or touch. Think about something that you can describe but do not experience it with the five senses. Abstract nouns are something that you can feel from within. It cannot be touched physically. A few examples. Happiness is an abstract noun as it cannot be touched, smelled, seen, heard, or tasted. It is a feeling. We cannot see, touch, smell, eat, or hear intelligence, so it is an abstract noun. A few other examples are anger, love, boredom, kindness, and honesty. Comparing. See the difference between concrete and abstract nouns in a better way. So laughter is a concrete noun because we can hear laughter. We do hear people laughing, but we cannot hear happiness. Happiness can only be felt and not heard, ate, touched, smelled, or seen. Yes, we can see someone expressing happiness, but by a smile, but that is not happiness. We know how a smile looks like because we have seen it, which makes it a concrete noun. But we don't know how happiness looks like because it cannot be seen by eyes. It can only be felt. So hence, it is an abstract noun. Friend is also a concrete noun. Here the term friendship is abstract. Friendship is a relationship between people. It is something that cannot be seen, but it is there as a feeling. A winner is a concrete noun, and we can see a winner. We can touch a winner. So it uses our senses, but we cannot see or touch victory. We cannot eat it or smell it. So victory is an abstract noun, and winner is a concrete noun. Verbs and adjectives to abstract nouns. Now, happy is neither a concrete noun, it's nor an abstract noun. Happy is a verb. A verb is a word that describes an action of a person. We say that he is very happy, so in this sense, happy is a verb. Yet, happiness is an abstract noun, like how I explained earlier. So, happy is neither concrete nor abstract. It is a verb, and happiness is an abstract noun. Do not get confused between these. Again, sad is a verb, as we say this person is very sad, so describes what that person is doing. And sadness is an abstract noun. Some more kind of differences are speed, fast and speed, beautiful and beauty, kind and kindness, loyal and loyalty. So just a short summary. Concrete nouns are something that can be smelled, tasted, heard, touched, and seen. Abstract nouns are an emotion or something that can be felt from within and not identified by the five senses. So guys, if you learned something new from this video, please remember to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and share this video with your family and friends. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.